Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. I swear to God, during the break, we were making jokes about Darth Vader going fishing. Someday that'll be its own show. Be right after Family Guy. We're talking to Mr. Hugh Rowland from Ice Road Truckers, author of the new book, On Thin Ice, Breakdowns, Whiteouts, and Survival on the World's Deadliest Roads. We have viewer Melissa who asks this question about Freightliner and Western Star. She says, Western Star was purchased by Freightliner a few years back. She says, I've always heard that these are the best trucks in the world. Is that true? All things being equal, is there a fundamental difference from one truck to the next?
Most trucks have the same drive lines, the same engines. It's the cab and chassis, suspension is all different on every one of them. Myself, that's what I like. I like Western Stars and international trucks. They're basically because they're big cabs, seat swivel, you got room to get up and put your heavy winter gear on. Plus, the parts are a little cheaper.
My grandfather, to the day he died, had a picture above his kitchen table from Freightliner, and it was a photograph of he and my uncle standing in front of the 100,000th truck to come off the line at Freightliner. People always make the comparison of truckers and trucks to cowboys and horses, and I think you hear that there is this special attachment to that vehicle or to that machinery that people might not appreciate. Is that true, or is that just a myth?
No, that's probably true. I mean, a lot of the old guys, they like Peterbilts and Kenworths, but they're highway haulers. Up there, it's a little different story. You're living in your truck. You need something that, you're in your truck 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so you have to have some room. I mean, you got a fridge in there. You've got coolers in there. You've got all your clothes are in there for the 2 months that you're up there. So you need the... They call my rigs the condos. They call them big condo shacks. Well, that's what they are. They're 74 inches long, and I can get up and we could have a barn dance in some of them. So.
You should just tell people you've got a jacuzzi inside. Don't ever let them. I'd let you in, but it's the models have filled up the whole thing. I'm sorry. Maybe
yeah,
next
for
trip.
Sure.
I got nothing. The camera guys who are going along on Ice Road Truckers, sometimes, obviously, it's either a recreation or it's an automated camera. It's a camera that's just put in there and they let it run. Sometimes, though, there's clearly a real person in there. And I often wonder how terrified the camera guy is at some point. You know, when, again, you hear the thunder clap of the ice breaking everywhere, the camera guy is just praying to the god of his understanding to get him out of there.
Yeah, lots of times the camera guys. Like I said, one year there, I went through three or four camera guys, and the field producers and stuff, a lot of them just can't take it. They go home quick. But most of them, they don't mind riding with me. I mean, I play it pretty safe. I've got about two camera guys in the last 4 years that I actually, I probably wouldn't do the show if it wasn't for them. I get along pretty good with them, and they know what they're doing. I don't put up with any BS from them, and I'll throw them out of the truck if they're causing me problems.
There's occasionally you'll see a moment on the show where the narrator, they reconstruct it retrospectively, and they say, you know, what he doesn't know is he's more than 100 miles off course and heading into a blizzard and an avalanche and a field of jagged ice. And you're watching, and I feel my blood pressure rise.
You dodge a couple of them, then the avalanche might get you.
I was just going to go to avalanches. I think actually in the press materials for this book, it says something like, ask Hugh for his tips on surviving an avalanche. Hugh, should it ever occur to me to remember these things as I'm being swallowed up by a mountain of snow, how do I survive that?
Just put your hammer down. Jump in the sleeper. If you go down over the
bank.
Get
in the jacuzzi.
Yeah, jump in the jacuzzi. You might drown then, but jump in the sleeper and ride her out. Yeah.
I don't think that's going to help me. That'll help you, not me so much. Well, for writing a fantastic book and being part of a great show, really, thanks so much for spending some time with
us. You bet. Thanks for having me on here.
And best of continued success in all things, my friend.
Right on. Thanks.
You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. My name is Rick Emerson. If you find me even moderately amusing, you can find out more about me at rickemerson.com. Until next time, insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next week right here on Outlook Portland, Northwest 32 TV. And now, with an Outlook Portland editorial reply, Things from Another World presents Magic the Gathering's Thornscape Battle Mage.
People of Portland, I, a humble elf wizard, beseech you. Learn how to merge, all right? And use your turn signal. I mean, use it to indicate that you plan to change lanes sometime before you actually begin moving over in front of me when I'm just trying to get downtown before Burnside becomes a parking lot. And back on merging for just a moment, here's a concept for you. It's called taking turns. When two lanes are becoming one, Alternate, okay? Left, right, left, right, like a zipper. That way we all get into one lane without having an embolism from the stress of figuring out whether that microbus is going to move or not. Remember, people of Portland, a car is not a toy, and a freeway is not your training ground. Thank you.
This has been an Outlook Portland editorial reply featuring Magic the Gathering's Thornscape Battle Mage, brought to you by Things from Another World. Whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection.